this is Nivedha, and I've come all the way from Bangalore to meet you all. So I thought I'll get you a gift. Any guesses on what the gift might contain? Any guesses? Chocolates? Okay. So for the benefit of the crowd, let me try uncovering whatever is there in this gift. So you have a plastic cover, a big plastic cover, inside which you have another plastic cover. Let me just uncover it for you. Any guesses now? So I've got you khakras, I've got you cover, I've got you, well, what is this? I have diaper, sanitary napkins, medicine, dal, blood. Imagine hundreds of these black bags. Imagine thousands of these black bags littered across a street. That's how the street outside my house looked like. Every day the same sight, and by the end of the day, they used to burn it off. The fumes and the smell used to choke us all, and I cribbed every day. But one day I decided, I'm going to clear this entire stretch. And I convinced a team of people who came along with me, and we cleaned this entire stretch. It was a very happy moment. The street was clean. But just within 1 week, the same number of bags reappeared, not one bag less. I realized I had failed, and I had failed miserably. Because I was not just having the solution, I was nowhere close to solving the solution. And that's when I realized to solve the actual problem, I had to find the root cause. And the root cause was interesting. Now see this plastic cover, if it is the way it is, you can recycle it like this. But the moment the plastic cover has sambar sticking onto it, like you can see here, I can't pick it up, it's dripping, it is rendered useless. You cannot recycle it. What I mean by that is it will end up as waste in front of your house. So it's clear. I went door to door and told the people, look, keep biodegradable and non-biodegradable separate. It will not end up in front of your house. Very clear. But all my cries and efforts ended up in vain. And that's when it hit me hard that my own chacha who has diabetes, I can't go and convince him not to eat sweets. How am I going to convince the entire locality to change overnight, and for that matter, even the next few decades? And I realized I can't change myself. How will I change 1.2 billion people in India, and for that matter, 7 billion people in the world? So this solution was not just not practical, it was not feasible. So I realized I've again failed. I don't know the solution. But I wanted to find that there should be some solution. No, this problem is so huge. Waste is all over. But despite my efforts, despite my extensive research, I found no technology in the world, no technology in the world that could handle this waste, this tough kind of waste. And that's when I got a ray of hope. I thought, what if I create a system that can take this kind of waste, segregate it automatically into biodegradable and non-biodegradable, and then recycle it. Because the moment I recycle, it will not end up as waste. The idea was very clear. The concept was very simple. So I was very excited, and I pitched this idea to scientists, engineers, all the industrialists and people working in the industry from the past 40, 45 years. And all of them listened to me and said one thing in common. They said, Nivedha, it's impossible. What you're trying to solve is not possible. Many people have come and burnt their hands. We have worked for 40 years. We have not seen any solution. All of this will not get solved. I listened to them. It was very convincing. I was just entering the field, and there was a person who has been in the field for 40 years telling me it is not possible. Very convincing. And they said, Nivedha, look, be wise. You're very young. You have a job offer in your hand. Go do your job. Why are you doing all this? But then, there were other thoughts running in my head. Other thoughts of people around me who were falling ill because of the burning of waste. My own friends who had mosquitoes breeding all around their houses. And one incident that made me take this option. There was this little girl, a little girl who is 3 years old. And she was playing in this street, giggling and laughing with her friends. And She slipped. She slipped into a burning pile of garbage. She slipped into a burning pile of garbage and she died with the most horrible screams and pain that you and I can never imagine. That day, I was torn apart and I asked myself, is it your mistake? Is it my mistake? Is it the waste mistake? Whose mistake is it? And if everybody starts giving up thinking that it is impossible, who will actually solve the problem that will kill many more children now? And that's when I decided, somebody has to solve the problem, why not me? But then at that time, I was just 21. I'm from a very middle class background with absolutely no savings. And I had no money. I had no team. Who will buy this idea? I had no team. I had absolutely nothing, no ray of hope that can possibly help me start. But again, the cries, the groan, the pain of that little child was larger than all my limitations. And I just jumped into it. I just jumped into it without even thinking about the consequences that was to come. But the next 8 months was not even close to what I expected. Next 8 months looked something like this. I used to get up in the morning, take a bus, take a metro, again take a bus to go to the dump site, to go to the dump site and work amidst rag pickers. I was the only one. I had no team for 8 months because nobody was ready to join me in this madness. But this continued for 8 months, me trying to figure out what is the difference between biodegradable and non-biodegradable, me trying to create a system. I got a small system, I tried doing every day and waste kept slapping me on my face because waste is so dynamic. One day I'm happy, the next day I'm disappointed. This happened, but it was that little child's face that kept coming and I kept asking myself, if not me, who? And at the end of eight months, I did have a small unit that I considered was to solve the world's biggest menace. And I was very happy. And had done my own small tests on it. And then I called all those people who told that I can't do it, all those people who told it is impossible. I said, you know what? I have done it. And they said, okay, let's see what she has done. Let's go and see. Chalo dekhte hain. And then they came. And then I switched on the machine. And it ran for 5 seconds. And at the end of the 5 seconds, the motor literally jumped out of the machine. And the machine broke down. The sound of the breaking of the machine and their laughter and mocking me just broke me. And they were like, we told you it is not possible. We told you it is not possible. This will not happen. And at that day, something happened to me. Something happened to me and I decided that yes, they are right. That it is not possible, that there is no solution, and I believed that there is no solution. I was all convinced, yes, there is no solution. All this time, I was just doing nonsense. And then I call my mother and I say, Mama, I am going to quit whatever I'm going to do and I'm going to take up a job. Anyways, people have to die, they will die with waste one day. And that day my mother said, she asked me, have I asked you to do something in life? Have I asked you to get good grades or get a good job? I said, no. She said, but today I'll ask you something. I'll ask you something on behalf of everybody I know, I'm aware of, and I love. There is a problem that is going to kill us all. And nobody is trying to solve it. Why can't my daughter at least try to solve it? She said, it's okay if you fail. But try. Try until all the possibilities are exhausted. I will support you with whatever meager salary I have. And this angel changed my life. She changed my life and made me go continue this particular path. And I continued. I continued and I'm glad I continued. I'm glad I spent the next few months in the dump sites. This angel changed me completely. But then, I'm glad I continued because otherwise I wouldn't have met the most amazing co-founder who would compliment me in every way. I'm glad I continued, otherwise I wouldn't have met this team of amazing people who would join me in this crazy mission, leaving their lofty jobs. I am glad I continued, because otherwise I wouldn't have ended up the next 1 year in hardships and adventure trying to figure out the solution. I am glad I continued, because today the system that was considered impossible by everybody around me, the system that was considered impossible by me myself, is functional and operational. As we speak, tens of thousands of kgs of waste are being segregated and generating value. From this waste, we are making products that people are using. I'm glad I continued, because today, the women who were touching waste with their own hands are dignified supervisors who operate my machine. I'm glad I continued, because I could see their smiles and satisfaction. Friends, I'm glad I continued, because if you see my journey, I had more downs than ups. But in every one of those downs, I grew up to be a better person. I got closer to my higher self. And most importantly, it drove me to make an impact of billions of lives. Today, I'm telling you that most of you have this dream that you consider is impossible, this dream that others around you will tell is impossible. But I'll tell you, just jump into it. Just jump into it and let it come. Because I'll tell you, there is nothing extraordinary about me. I'm half as skilled as most of you here. I'm half as talented as most of you here. But if there is one thing that I did throughout the entire journey, is that I survived. I survived every time it slapped me hard. And that's all it takes. Failure is when you decide to fail. There is no such thing as failure. And that's what I've realized. So go ahead and make your impossible dreams come true. There was once a day when I saw this bag of waste and it made me feel helpless. It made me feel useless. What is your thing that makes you feel helpless? Thank you so much.